Thousands of anti-government protesters have once again packed the streets of Hong Kong in the 16th straight weekend of demonstrations. Riot police were seen firing tear gas at a crowd who built barricades and threw petrol bombs. Authorities are facing renewed allegations of brutality, but warn if the violence gets any worse, they may have to use live ammunition to defend themselves. You're currently looking at live pictures in Hong Kong. Police are trying to disperse protesters, staging a sit-in at the same train station where demonstrators were attacked by a mob 2 months ago. CNN's Will Ripley is following these developments from Hong Kong and joins us now live. Certainly a lot of action. It's just on 11 p.m. where you are, Will. Take us through what's happening.
It's proving to be a pretty effective police dispersal operation outside of Prince Edward Station here in Mong Kok. This was the scene of an incident involving police last month where police were accused of excessive force. There were rumors, uncorroborated, and in fact, we have not been able to confirm, but there have been rumors that are being spread widely amongst protesters that protesters were killed. Again, no evidence that that's actually the case, but that is what's brought people out here and why they are shouting at these police officers who are basically now circling the area around Prince Edward Station, going to the different entrances, including, by the way, this one, which is closed, and you can see there's protester posters and propaganda plastered all over the shuttered entrance of Prince Edward Station. And you have police officers who are out here. As far as I can see, they are not armed, but they are, they obviously have their riot gear. Some of these people are, look about as young as a lot of the protesters, and you can even see them in street clothes with sneakers and t-shirts. It seems as if it's really all hands on deck at this point as Hong Kong police continue to try to keep up with the protests, working 12-hour shifts overnight every single weekend. And so you have, this is the scene. Something just got lobbed at us here. It looks like somebody threw a tin something at us. And police officers are facing this. They have protesters shouting every swear you can imagine in the book, in English, in Cantonese. And so they have people pointing laser pointers at them. So they're walking around basically just trying to make sure that the roads stay open, that the crowds stay relatively orderly, even as they endure a significant amount of verbal abuse. So we've just been walking around for the last hour with these officers, Linda, and they're allowing us to do so. This is the police side over here, the crowds of protesters. And this is a scene that we see play out time and time again here on the streets of Hong Kong. Earlier today, things got more violent than what we're seeing here right now, and I think we have video of that. There was protesters hurling petrol bombs and bricks at police officers, and police fired back with tear gas. The kind of scenes that would have been unimaginable here in Hong Kong just a short time ago, yet now are kind of the sad new reality of life here, really with no end in sight. Even though the crowds are smaller, this continues to happen. Linda.
Will, from the pictures we're seeing right now, it looks like there is a real show of force from riot police, but unclear from our perspective at least how many protesters there are. Last hour when we spoke, you said you were seeing about 100, maybe a few hundred. Have more people come out? Because it certainly sounds to be a very vocal group.
That's partially because Hong Kong is an urban jungle, and so the noise bounces off the concrete. I think the crowds are probably smaller than when we checked in with you last hour, Linda. Look, this is an interesting thing. Just pan up there. So police, you know, they have people pointing lasers at them, so they're pointing their own flashlights back at the people who are firing the laser beams, trying to, you know, essentially blind each other. But it's whack-a-mole, because if there's a crowd, the police have now moved down that way. Sometimes they run. They clear them out, and then the crowd appears somewhere else, and police go there. But it seems as if it's this kind of dance that's been perfected week after week. And even as the protest movement gets smaller, they're still managing to keep Hong Kong police definitely on their toes.
All right, Will Ripley for us in Hong Kong. Good to have you there, as always. Thanks so much.